Welcome back to Elden Ring. Let's explore more of the Altus Plateau. I want to check out more of this valley. So we already looked at the southern little spot of this valley. Let's go north. That leads to this whole really weird, interesting structure here, full of jagged rocks. There's a cave here, and then also I think we should be able to get to this large castle too. So yeah, let's go north. Of War Bloodblade. You have fun up there. Oh, their friend killed them. Are you? Oh, I think we fought those in Lake Liurnia. Maybe? Maybe not. I'm not sure. It's a spirit spring over there. Wait, so that... Oh, that goes to the cave. Are they talking about the giant or talking about this person? Are you not what you look like? Oh, they're exactly what they look like. Two keys for this one. Old Altus Tunnel. Yeah, they won't attack me. I have the beast torch. Oh, doggy. How'd you get over here? Oh, good jump. Which way do I want to go first? Up there or down there? I don't know, maybe up first? Lightning protection. Okay, so we have to go down. Troll's hammer. Eight strength, 8 dex, and 10 faith. Huh, bit of a faith weapon, and it does fire damage. Mining tool of stone digger trolls used to crack bedrock. Trolls are descended from the giants, and these were supposedly once used as ceremonial smithing tools. In the distant past, smithing was considered divine. Many people at once, and I don't want to fight the dogs. Yes, come on up. It's a little pathway back there. Ooh, giant ahead, weak foe. Oh my God. Why are you so easy to kill? Great club. +35 strength. Enormous club of hard wood. Wildly hammering foes with this striking weapon requires no dexterity, only brute force. While it may seem sacrilegious, this weapon is said to be a withered branch of the Erd tree. Imbued with holy power, this weapon will never snap. Hole. Yep. That's a hole, kinda. Is that all there is to this place, or did I miss a pathway? I'm gonna take a quick look. Yeah, that really seems to be it. Let's keep going north in the valley. Well, I don't actually want to be on this upper part, is the thing. Wait, I'm confused. What? Wait, huh? Oh, I didn't actually have to go up. I thought that was the only way forwards. No, it's not. Yeah, we're coming to the castle. S- So it's surrounded by a poison swamp. I guess the green water kind of gives that away on the map. Sight of grace. I guess let's just get down there. Oh, they're all congregating around the poison bloom. That makes sense. I don't think there's really a reason to kill all the poison slugs. The Shaded Castle. Three notes here? I really don't think this is a secret thing, though. It doesn't look like it'd be. Message ahead. Could this be a door? What a surprise. It's not. I guess I'll get that Sight of Grace real quick. Oh. Let's make it daytime. Easier to explore. Ooh, Scarlet Rot. I'm just trying to get the flower, though. Come on, grab it. There we go. Oh my god, I just realized you can see that Torrin's hooves are all, like, green from being in the nasty water. Oh, cool. Hmm. Maris or Maurice Shaded Castle Castellan. You're gonna be like that, aren't you? Yeah, they're really good at dodging. All right then, how about Ambushard? Okay, I think I have to be facing it, otherwise it seems to go in a real wonky direction. Okay, that's not working too well. Night Comet. Antspur Rapier and their mask and robe. Ooh. It's really better just to go melee, isn't it? I gotta see what that message is. Try fingers butthole. Okay, it's on literal fingers. I'm gonna upvote that. Sorry. Anyway, we have the weapon. What was it? Antspur Rapier. It's a bit of a dex weapon. 10 strength, 20 dex. Oh, it causes scarlet rot buildup. Oh. Is that the first weapon that just causes scarlet rot buildup that I've gotten? If it's not the first one, then at least it's one of the very few. Spur of a giant ant, which has been fashioned into a rapier. The blade drips with scarlet rot. Scarlet Rot is an old legend of which Malay Maurice of the Shaded Castle was a private believer, and indeed, he eventually found his own personal goddess. Oh, it looks so cool. Look at that. Actually, now that I think of it, I think we got a dagger that was also made from some poison thing, and I think also did Scarlet Rot. But God, that could be so powerful, because Scarlet Rot is basically like poison, but much more effective. Vastly more effective. I want to see what that looks like. Oh, that is so cool. The special isn't very special, though. You can put whatever one you want on it. Oh, I'm intrigued by the Scarlet Rot. How heavy is it? 3. No, it's quite light. I'm going to leave that on there. I want to upgrade it. Try it out. An entrance up there. I could easily jump up there. Let's check around back first, though. Yeah, these things are probably immune to Scarlet Rot. No, wait, actually. Yeah, it has Scarlet Rot on it right now. The only, like, 20 damage per tick, which I feel like it would be a lot better if it was on something else. Well, I guess I'm here now. Oh no. Actually, this is a good place to fight it. Ah. Yes. Oh, and now I can't use torrent, so I'm gonna have to step foot in this stuff. What is it, Scarlet Rot? No, just normal poison. Okay. Well, let's put on something for that. Resistance to poison and rot. Okay. Well, at least you can sprint in this stuff. It's not gooey. Just poisonous. Oh. Depraved perfumer headscarf. I guess we know what they are. Oh, you sneaky. Can I get a double? Oh, almost. Here. Ah, still missed it. Before I forget, because I already kind of forgot, I should look at the pieces of armor I got from them. Marais mask. Mask in the image of a white-haired young noble, customarily worn by the head of House Marais, increases arcane by one. The Marais family has a dual history spanning generations, serving as both executioners and castellans of the Shaded Castle. This mask bears the likeness of the first of their line. God, look how covered in blood I am. Oh, that is so cool. That looks so cool. Of course, it's not very me, but it's very cool. Like, are the eye holes even where my eyes are? I kind of think they're not. No, not really. The other one was, I think, yeah, the robe. It's really cool. Yeah, it is really cool, but it's not a dress. I want more dresses. You have Estus flasks? Hmm. How will those gloves look? Ooh. Those are quite elegant. They're nice and tight on the skin. Wear them as a change of pace. Matches the color of my shoes, kind of. I keep making the mistake of rolling in the poison goo, and I think that is what makes your poison go up like it is right now, even though I'm not touching it, because you get kind of covered in it, I guess is the idea, which totally makes sense. Rolling in it's definitely worse than just stepping in it, so yeah, I need to stop rolling in it. See if I can get all four. Oh, just do. Where are you right? That probably was coming from the other end, I think. Whoops. Try tree to get that item up there. Okay. I guess I got to jump onto the tree. Or maybe a different tree. Because I can't use my horse. I don't know. Oh, we're back here. Well, I kind of desperately need FP. Let's actually get one more FP potion. Yeah, let me see if I can use that tree. Because I can't torrent here. No. Haha. Jump up there. Oh, they probably did it from here. Yeah. Ooh, some items down there. Ah, too many ways to go. Not that way. Nothing that way. Yes, this way. I see a painting in there. Wait, what? Try here. Ah, thank you. Champion's Song Painting. Be wary of jumping. Why? What's wrong with jumping? champion songs, so we see the jagged rocks in the background. A statue in the foreground. I don't think I've seen a statue like that. You. Oh, yeah. Wow, I guess that's how you're intended to get it. It's actually quite difficult. Stone sword key. Add that to the pile. Okay, I think the next place to go is up this ladder. I think that'll take us deeper into the castle. Because we've just been, so far we've just been on this outer wall and then this like inner courtyard. Got a big boy here. Jump over there. We already go down there. Oh, I guess not. There's an item down there. Knight ahead, try jump attack. Ooh. Oh no! Oh. I can give that to Millicent, right? Golden prosthesis used by the one-armed Valkyrie. A masterwork of craftsmanship, with practice and skill, it can be used as proficiently as a real arm. When Malay Maurice, I think I pronounce that a different way every time, Maurice, Lord of the Shaded Castle, embraced this prosthesis, he claimed to feel the presence of his personal goddess. There's that item down there. It's not the way I want to go to get it, though. And then I can jump over up here. Let's jump over. I don't want to waste tons of FP on the wormy dudes. Could this be a treasure chest? Kind of looks like it. Oh, Sight of Grace. Shaded Castle Inner Gate. Yeah, before we explore any further, let's go back to Millicent.
Are you giving me this arm? Thank you. I am in your debt yet again, I think. If the arm serves well enough, it might be possible for me to wield a sword again. If the arm serves, it might be possible. Perhaps then I can aid you in battle.
I wonder when we'll see them again. Let's get the item that I missed down here. I think that's it. Looks like it. Still don't have Smithing Stone 3s. Back to the Shaded Castle Inner Gate. Oh, I suppose... yeah, this inside part doesn't have acid as far as I can tell. So I can probably switch this out. With the faster spellcasting one. Be wary of dog. I'm not worried about any dogs. House Moraes is ruined. Just deserts for falling for that severed harpy. No surprise that guilty cretin took the castle and our storied sword. Falling for a severed harpy. Got a ladder up over that way. And then I think a ladder down? Or just a place to fall down? No, there's a ladder down. Oh, I haven't actually gone down here yet, have I? Well, I don't feel like putting the protection talisman back, so meh. I'll be fine. Oh, there's like extra deep stuff where you can't sprint it, and it also makes your poison go up super fast. But it's not all like this. It should be good here. Cover myself in the swamp water, it doesn't matter. I'm infected. Try this ladder. Actually, it ended up mattering because now it's going up constantly. Ah, we're good. Shortcut, I suppose. I don't know why I'd need to use that. Oh, they were trying to reach the perfume bottle. That's what the big boy was going for. Oh, just out of reach. So that just leaves down the ladder and through the front, or up the ladder. Let's try going up the ladder. Puppies. Oh no, they can do that nasty three burst of flame arrows. Strong foe ahead, seek precious item. There's something up that ladder. Oh, this leads to a whole thing. So let's go up the ladder first. Perfumer's Cookbook 2. poisons, spray mist, and blood boil aromatic. Don't I already have poison spray mist? Is that a different one? Or are there overlaps sometimes? Oh, acid spray mist is what I had before. Poison spray mist. Huh. So then what did acid spray mist do? Did it not do damage over time? Maybe that's why it seemed like it was so ineffective. Maybe it literally wasn't doing damage over time. I don't know. And then there's this. Uses FP to enter a temporary state of fervor. Yeah, I don't know what that means. I mean, I know what fervor means, but like, what does it actually mean gameplay mechanic wise? Oh, here we go. Temporary state of fervor, raising maximum attack power and stamina while also increasing damage received. Ooh. Even upon the battlefield, do you fear being wounded? Take a good look. Your limbs are frozen stiff. Yeah, so it's a very high-risk item. You gain 30% more physical damage, which is a huge, but you take, or rather, your damage negation is reduced by 25%. But 30% physical damage increased. I think it's only physical damage, though, I'm pretty sure. So I don't think it would affect spells. Well, okay, that's not fair. If you're not going to be fair, then I'm going to use Nebula. Oh yeah, so that's like the front place where I dropped down. So the only thing that was waiting for me there is an item. Oh, they're staring right at me. Oh, I see the sword. Sorry, doggies. It's fine, it's fine. Shh. Oh, because I heard it, I think it's not gonna give up. Sorry, doggy. Another shortcut ladder, I guess. Is that really a shortcut? I guess it is. We have a boss coming up. What is with the statues? Try Nimble Sword. Okay. Well, I have tons of FP, only 2 health potions. Take a flask and some exalted flesh, I suppose. We'll try Comet. Elemer of the Briar. Jesus. Oh, I already drank it. No wonder I'm doing terrible damage. I didn't even have my weapon equipped. That's a really tough one. Morace Executioner's Sword and the Briar Great Shield. Strength, 24 strength, 14 dex, and 23 arcane. Oh, that'd be a really cool weapon to wield. Iokide's Dancing Blade is the special. Oh. Storied Sword of House Morace, the family of executioners who presided over the Shaded Castle, one of the legendary armaments. Elemer of the Briar, the bell-bearing hunter, snatched the sword from the site of his looming execution and furnished it with battle skills from his home of Iokide. Iokide's Dancing Blade, infused the sword with energy, then fling it forwards in a corkscrew attack. The sword continuously deals damage while violently spinning. Charge the attack to increase reach and duration of the spin. Oh, will it let us do that? Even though we don't have the strength or the arcane? Can I just see it? No. Let's level up. Let's get Dex. Then there's the Briar Great Shield. Only 21 strength, actually. Not too bad. But of course, no one's going to two-hand a shield, so I would need to be able to one-hand that. And I'm 4 strength short. I think that's it for the Shaded Castle. So I think I'm going to end this episode here. Hope you've enjoyed so far. When I return, more exploring of the Altus Plateau.